92 in old London town. The Cornfoots were a-starving as the snow lay on the ground. And so in desperation, Jimmy Cornfoot stole some bread. But not just any bread, they were Hovis, best of both. But Jimmy was arrested, then dragged off to the court. Not the one with tennis, but the, you know, legal sort. The judge roared, "Transportation!" Jimmy quivered in the stand.
"I'm sending you 12,000 miles to Van Diemen's Land."
Then a year and a day after Jimmy sailed away, his brother Brian got a letter one cold winter's day. And his heart began to warm as he opened it and read the words from his dear brother, and this is what it said.
"Oh, Australia, oh, Australia, it's a land of golden beaches, bright blue skies and crystal seas. Oh, Australia, oh, Australia.
If you just ignore the bushfires, it's the place to be." Brian Cornfoot thought, "You know, well, that's the place for me." So he stole a rich man's horse and crashed it straight into a tree. The judge roared,
"Transportation!"
Brian smiled back from the stand.
"I'm sending you 12,000 miles to that demon's land."
Then a year and a day after Brian sailed away, his sister Connie got a letter one cold winter's day. And her heart began to warm as she opened it and read the words from her dear brother, and this is what it said.
"Oh, Australia, oh, Australia, it's a land of golden beaches, bright blue skies and crystal seas. Oh, Australia, oh, Australia.
If you just ignore the bushfires, deadly spiders, poisonous snakes, it's the place to be." Connie Cornfoot thought, "You know, well, I want some of that." So she punched a policeman in the face, then peed into his hat. The judge roared,
"Transportation!"
Connie sniggered in the stand.
"I'm sending you 12,000 miles to Van Diemen's Land."
Then a year and a day after Connie sailed away, Mother Cornfoot got a letter one cold winter's day. And her heart began to warm as she opened it and read the words from her dear daughter, and this is what it said.
"Oh, Australia, oh, Australia, it's a land of golden beaches, bright blue skies and crystal seas. Oh, Australia, oh, Australia.
Ignore the bushfires, deadly spiders, poisonous snakes, vicious crocodiles and stingrays, it's the place to be." Gentle Mother Cornfoot thought, "I need to join the kids." So she rang a neighbor's doorbell and then ran away and hid. But then behind a lamppost she was dragged off to the stand, where the judge roared,
"Mother Cornfoot, for this crime you'll surely hang."
"Whoa, whoa, whoa, they're hanging for cherry knocking. And they call that justice. Sounds a bit ropey to me." "Ropey?" Sorry.
The hangman said,
"Today's the day you'll swing here in the breeze."
Mother Cornfoot took a breath and sank down on her knees, her eyes fixed on the masses that had come to see her dead. She raised her voice up to the skies, and this is
what she said.
Oh, Australia. Oh, Australia. It's a land of golden beaches, bright blue skies and crystal seas. Oh, Australia. Oh, Australia.
If you just ignore the bushfires, deadly spiders, poisonous snakes, vicious crocodiles and stingrays, lethal jellyfish and sharks, Danny Minogue, it's the place to be.
Oh, Australia, oh, Australia. It's a land of golden beaches, bright blue skies and crystal seas. Oh, Australia, oh, Australia.
If you just ignore Australia, it's the place to be. And as they put the noose around her neck, Mother Cornfoot cried,
"Who'll come a-waltzing Matilda?"